turn your eyes from me, for my love be your face from me, for my light has surely come, surely come, surely
soldiers take him away. My efforts to stop it, like a lot of other things I did that night, were in vain. I fell asleep thrice when he asked us to wait and woke up to his gentle voice. Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for an hour? I can't imagine what he felt. The hour has come, he said, as the soldiers arrived with Judas. He thought I would deny him. He said I would. He was right. When the young servant girl said, aren't you one of this man's disciples? I am not, I replied quickly. Strike one. Overwhelmed with guilt, I moved away from the gate and stood around the fire. Again, a stranger's voice breaking my silence. Aren't you one of his disciples too, are you? The crowd was bigger this time. What if I said I knew him? What would they do to me? No, I am not, I said. Ashamed. Strike two. Don't look at me like that. You weren't there. You don't know what it was like. I was afraid for my life. And to think, just a few hours ago, when the soldiers came to take Jesus away, I was quick to attack the first man I saw, cutting off his right ear. In my heart I was screaming, look, Lord, I haven't denied you. I won't let them take you away. Put your sword away, Peter, he said to me. Shall I not drink the cup that the Father has given me? He then proceeded to heal the man and surrender to the soldiers. The final challenge presented itself around the fire. A relative of the man I attacked asked, did I not see you in the garden with him? Cursing myself, I swore, I do not know this man of whom you speak. And like clockwork, the second those words left my mouth, I heard the rooster crowing in the distance. Strike three. And Jesus looked at me. He looked at me, he saw right through me. His eyes spoke kindness, even though he knew what I had done. The crowd around the fire dispersed, and I wept like never before. How was I any better than Judas? He betrayed the Lord, but never denied him. How was I any better than the soldiers killing Jesus? How could he ever forgive me? How could I ever forgive myself?
I tempered the storm, though your faith was small. I prayed while you slept, and the night raged warm. Stood by the fire.
I wonder what the sacrifice would be. Wonder what people would say about this cross and this man who willingly submitted to suffering, obediently accepting a cruel punishment that he did not deserve. The Messiah, he who bore no sin. Wonder if we would forget what he endured. Wonder if this would be futile. Wonder if the irony of this gruesome scene being the greatest act of love would somehow be lost in translation. Wonder if we would learn that he embodied all his teachings. Wonder if the fact that our Savior did not save himself, that our victor did not defend himself. While the heavens stood dark and hostile while the Messiah died, would be his immense love for us. Sin is an exhaustingly expensive affair. He bore the weight he bore, the guilt he carried, the price he paid, the prayer he prayed. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Father, forgive us. Father, forgive me. Father, forgive.
Lift up your eyes and see. Heaven is closer than hell. Lift up your voice and sing. Know that my love won't let you. Your eyes and see, heaven is closer than you. No one ever leave you, so lift up your voice and sing. Know that my love won't let you. Surely come, surely come, surely come. And I'm closer than you.